In this video, we're going to take a look at the track matte key effect. This is pretty much all you'll need to know to use it as a transition or make video play through text. So what does a track matte do? When you have a clip with black and white in it, it will make the black or white transparent so it can show through the underlying layer. On my timeline here, this top track is the matte and it is a clip. So if I turn off these other two tracks and I just scroll through the clip, this is what can be used as a track matte. That depending on if it's black or white, it's going to show or hide the underlying layer. The two clips below it are the clips that we're going to use that are overlapping each other for our transition. The clip on V2 has the track matte key effect on it. And you can see in the program monitor up here where the lightest area is the area that is actually white in our track matte clip, and the other area is black. So if you look at V2, that is where the track matte key effect is. In the effects control, you see that the matte is on video 3, and that's this layer right here. And then the composite is set to matte luma. That means that anything that is in white will be fully transparent, but anything that is darker will be less transparent. And so that is with the luma option. Sometimes you'll set the composite to matte alpha. It will make the black part transparent and the white part will remain. So now let's see some examples. So in this first example, this is the effect we're going for. We're going to use graphic shapes to make our track matte transition. First, decide where you want to put your transition on your timeline. In this case, I have two clips on my timeline. I'm just drag one of my clips on top of the other and overlap the two clips a couple of seconds. Where these clips overlap is where my transition is going to be. Now hit the letter C on your keyboard or your razor tool and make a cut at the end of the bottom clip. Hit V to go back to your selection tool. We're going to use the clip on top for the actual transition. So now I'm going over to the tools panel. So now I'm going to drag my ellipse over to my program monitor. If I hold down shift, I can draw a perfect circle. And in the essential graphics panel, I'm going to fill this with white. So I want a white circle. Say okay. And now I want to make the graphic that I made on V3 the same size as my transition. So I'm going to resize that. Next, I'm going to animate the circle. So with the graphic selected, come over to the effects control panel and under shape and under transform, I'll click on position and scale for my keyframes. So now I'm going to zoom out my program window because I'm going to have to see where I've moved my circle out of the frames. So I'm going to change my position values so the circle is out of frame. So I'm just going to move this over and move it down a little bit and make sure it is out of frame. And you can see that this red box over here to the lower right of the frame is actually the circle. So that's how you know where it is. So now I'm going to lasso these keyframes and move these over to the beginning. For the next set of keyframes, I'm going to move the position so that the circle comes back in the frame. And I'm going to keep on moving it until it's kind of in the center of the frame. And I'm going to scale it up until it fills the whole frame, just like that. Now I'm going to select these two keyframes. I'm going to right click and come down and say ease in. I'm going to move these keyframes all the way over to the end and select the first keyframes. I'm going to right click and say ease out. And now on V2, where the second track is, I'm going to come up to my effects, search for track. There's track matte key. Drag that onto that second clip. Come over to the effects controls. Under matte, select video 3 because that is where my graphic is that I just made. Or composite, you can either try matte alpha or matte luma. Just to see what looks best, we'll go with matte alpha this time. And if I could just scroll slowly over the clip, you see the graphic coming over the clip. And here is the effect. Now you did all that work, and if you like your effect, what you do is you can actually save it and use it later in another project. So to do that, put this graphic layer on a timeline all by itself, just like this. Take all the other clips out, and then you can just export it and name it whatever you like. Choose match source, adaptive high bitrate, export it, and then bring it back into your project. And you can test it by bringing it back into your project. Take out the graphic layer that you made before and replace it on your timeline. And you may have to change your composite to matte luma, but you can test it. And now you can use it in another project. You already know how to set up your timeline. Just overlap your tracks, make a cut at the end of your bottom track, put your matte above the top track and make it the same size, and you're good to go. If you haven't yet subscribed, hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so you won't miss any of my tutorials. In this example, we can use a matte that has a video clip as its background. So I have a clip on the timeline and the Premiere Pro logo on the track above it, and I made it the same length as the clip below. In this case, the matte is the logo and you want the movie to show up behind it. So now I'm going to the effects panel and search for track and get the track matte key and drag it onto the bottom clip. And now with the video track selected, I'm going to go to the effects control, and under matte, I'm going to select video 2. And under Composite, I'm going to select Matte Luma because we want the lighter areas in the logo to show the video below. So the PR is the area that is going to show the video below. And this is what it looks like. In this next example, I placed a clip on the timeline and above it, a graphic I created in Photoshop with an alpha channel background on the track above it. Now, if we want the video to show through the text, I'll get the track matte key effect and put it on the video clip on the bottom and go over to matte and select video 2. And in this case, matte alpha works because this graphic was saved with an alpha channel. And now I can see the video through the letters. In this example, we're going to create a smoky transition from a scene where people are walking in a crowded marketplace to a scene where people are walking on the sidewalks in a big city. So just like before, decide where you want your transition. Here we're going to use this first clip as our transition, and this time we're going to put it above our second clip and overlap it as long as we need to, a couple seconds. Then make your cut so that your transition matches with the start of your bottom clip. Now for our mat, we're actually going to create a black color mat. You can come over here to where it says new item, this icon over here on the bottom, and select color mat, and it'll default to your width of your video settings. Say okay, and you can choose a color, and our color mat is already set to black up here in the far left corner. Say okay, choose a name for your color mat, say okay. Now drag your color mat over to your timeline and make it the same size as the track that you cut on V2. Then go over to your effects panel and search for something called VR Fractal Noise. Drag that onto your black color mat, and over here in the effects control, uncheck auto VR properties. In the drop down, select stereoscopic over under, set fractal type to turbulent sharp. As you see, we already have an effect in the program monitor. So now we're going to animate. Move the playhead to the beginning and hit the stopwatch for brightness, complexity, and evolution. So we have keyframes there started. For brightness, set it to minus 100. Complexity, set to 1. Evolution, set to 0. And I'll move to the back, and we'll set the brightness to 100. Complexity to 10, and evolution to 295. I'll select the track on V2. Come over here and get my track matte key effect. Drag it onto my clip on V2 where I have my cuts. Then I'll set matte to video 3. My composite I'll set to matte luma and click the reverse checkbox. And you can see there's the effect as I scroll through it. I'll play it back and there it is. And don't forget, you could save your effect. Just isolate the black color matte that we had created and add the effects on it. Export it out. Bring it back into your project. Bring it back into your timeline. Make sure it's the same size as your cutout. So we're testing it right now. And there you go. In another example, if you don't feel like creating your track matte from shapes or creating your effects from scratch, you can download track mats from a lot of places on the internet. There are some sites that have free stock video, and they also have effects, and they may have track matte effects. Sites like Adobe Stock, it will even tell you that it is a track matte effect, and sometimes it'll say it's matte luma or matte alpha. So once you download it, you already know how to set this up. Just have two overlapping clips. Cut your clip at the length you want the transition. Add your downloaded track matte to your project, then bring it over onto your timeline and just make it the same size as your transition. Make sure that it is all set right with your track matte key effect. And there it is, already made for you. Just put it in place. If you want more tutorials just like this, click on one of the videos on the screen now. If you haven't already, like, share, and subscribe. And remember, it's never too late to learn. Thanks for watching.